chemistry. The next chapter is noble gas elements. It is very interesting topic and it is useful for competitive examination like NEET, IIT, mains or JIMMA, any other competitive anywhere. So this is noble gas elements. So this what is the definition of noble gas elements? First, noble gas elements means they have completely filled valence shell with electronic configurations, are called noble gas elements. Its electronic configuration is NH2NP6. Its electronic configuration is NH2NP6. That means they have completely filled valence shell with electronic configurations, are called noble gas elements. Noble gas elements electronic configuration is NH2NP6. Of course, in every group, the first topic is electronic configuration. So what is the electronic configuration? Electronic configuration. Here electronic configuration, noble gas element electronic configuration is NH2NP6. Its elements are helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. Now here we take again helium, then neon, then argon, then krypton, and then xenon. Helium here 2, 10, 18, 36, 54. It is 1s2. Here 2s2, 2s2, 2p6. Here 3s2, 3p6. This is 3d10, 4s2, 4p6. This is 4d10, 5s2, 5p6. This is 4f14, 5d10, 6s2, 6p6. So what is the atomic number? Here atomos 2. That's why it atomic number is 2. Here 2 to 4 plus 6 10. Here 10 12 6 18. Here 18 28 30 36. Here 36 46 48 54. Here 54 68 78 80 86. So this is electronic configuration of noble gas elements. So this noble gas elements here NH2NP6 nothing but N is nothing but number of cells, S are called orbital, N number of cells, P are called orbital. So in this one, all except to helium, whose electronic configuration is NH2. All noble gas element electronic configuration is NH2NP6. Except to helium, whose electronic configuration is 1s2. All elements are monoatomic gas elements. All elements are monoatomic elements. And these noble gas elements are stable electronic configuration. That means they are chemically inactive. They are chemically inactive due to stable electronic configurations. So this is electronic configuration. All elements are monoatomic gas elements except to helium, whose electronic configuration is 1s2. Here helium is the gas, radon is the radioactive element. So this is electronic configuration. After that electronic configuration, we have to discuss xenon compounds. These xenon compounds are basically three types. That is, one, xenon halides, second one, xenon oxides, and third one, xenon oxyhalides. These halides are again three types. That is, one, HCF2, second one, HCF4, and third one, HCF6. These are again two type, that is HCO3, then next one HCO4. And these oxyhalates are again three type, HCOF4, HCOF2, HCO2F2. Now let us discuss one by one by one. Now let us first HCF2. In the HCF2, first we find oxidation state. How find oxidation states? We already discussed in the first year classes. So what is the oxidation state? Here, fluorine oxidation states are minus 1. That's why x plus 2 into minus 1 equal to 0, x minus 2 equal to 0, x equal to 2. Its oxidation state is 2. Simply, oxidation states are dependent upon unpaired electrons. So this is xenon. Xenon nothing but, so in this one, in this HCF2, its oxidation state is 2 nothing but, so its electronic configuration is NH2NP6. So here xenon is there. What is the xenon electronic configuration? 5S2 5P6. It is 5S2 5P6. This formula is as it is written or called ground state. So this is ground state. In ground state how much? S it contain 1, 2, and P contain 3 orbitals and 6 electrons. So that means here what is the oxidation state? Basically its oxidation state is 2. Its oxidation state is 2. The 2 oxidation states means 2 unpaired electrons will be taken place. In the ground state there is no unpaired electron on it. Unpaired electrons synthesis in first excitation state. That's why first excitation state. These lone pair electrons synthesis in that side. That side is the other side. So what happened here? S it contain 1, 2 and P contain 3 orbitals and 5 electrons, and D contain 5 orbitals, 1 electrons. In the first excitation state, 2 lone pair of electrons is there. So 2 bond pair, that means 2 unpaired, 2 oxidation states, 2 fluorine, all are equal. That's why its oxidation state, it undergoes sp3d hybridization. It undergoes sp3d hybridization, which means 1 s orbital, it's not electron, 1 s orbital, 3 p orbital, 1 d orbital combined to form 5 sp3d hybrid orbital is formed. These 5 sp3d hybrid orbitals undergoes its shape of the molecule is linear. Its shape of the molecule is linear. How does the structure of linear? The linear means xenon is the central metal. It contains 2 fluorine. 1, 2. Then how many paired electrons? 3. This is 1, 2, 3. So the shape, this is linear. So what is in this one? First, hybridization. What is the relation? SP3D. Shape of the molecule. Its shape of the molecule is linear. Lone pair. LP stands for lone pair. Lone pair of electron is 1, 2, 3. It is 3. Lone pair of electron is 3. Next, bond pair. Its bond pair of electron 1, 2. Its bond pair of electron is 2. Oxidation state. Its oxidation state of much? Plus 2. Its oxidation state is plus 2. And total number of orbital. Total number of orbital is 5. Total number of orbital is 5. So this is HCF2. So at the same time, HCF4. Its HCF4 means what is HCF4? Next one is HCF4. Here, HCF4. First, we find oxidation state. X plus 4 into minus 1 equal to 0. Simply x minus 4 equal to 0. X equal to what happened? 4. Now its oxidation state is 4. 4 unpaired electron. So as we similar to like this one only. So it is its electronic configuration is NH2 NP6. So this is what happened? ground state. That means this formula is as it is written or called ground state. S, how much it contain? 1, 2. And P contain 3 orbitals and 6 electrons. But in the ground state there is no unpaired electron on in it. Unpaired electrons are enters in first excitation state. Unpaired electrons are enters in first excitation state. So this is ground state. Now let us in the first excitation state. Simply stands for IE. So what happened here in this one? This lone pair of electron enters in that side. That side means D orbital side. S it contain 1, 2 and P contain 3 orbitals and 4, 5 electrons. And D contain 5 orbitals. And D contain 5 orbitals, 1 electrons. But here what is the oxidation state? Basically 4. 4 means 4 unpaired electrons will be take space. 4 oxidation state means 4 unpaired electrons will be take space. But in the ground state, first excitation state, only 1 unpaired electron is there. That means only 2 unpaired electrons is there. The remaining unpaired electrons enter in second excitation state. Now let us in the second excitation state. Yes, it contains 1, 2. And P contains 3 orbitals and 4 electrons. And D contain 5 orbitals and how many electrons? This lone pair enters in that side. 1, 2. So there are 4 unpaired electrons. So 4 oxidation state, 4 fluorine. That's why it undergoes sp3d2 hybridization. It undergoes sp3d2 hybridization, which means 1 s orbital, 3 p orbital, and 2 d orbital. Total 6 sp3d2 hybrid orbital is formed. These 6 sp3d2 hybrid orbitals undergoes its shape of the molecule is square planar. Its shape of the molecule is square planar. Now, how does the square planar structure? So, this is xenon is the central metal. So, it contains 1, 2, 3, 4. These are fluorine. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2 pair electron. This is one above the plane. Another one is below the plane. So what is in this one? First, hybridization. Hybridization, what is the hybridization? sp3d2. It's shape of the molecule. What is the shape of the molecule? Square planar. Square planar. What is the oxidation state? The oxidation state is plus 4. Lone pair. How many lone pair of electrons? 1, 2. Lone pair of electron is 2. Next, bond pair. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4. Bond pair is 4. The next excitation state. What is the excitation state? Second. Excitation state is second. This is XeF4. After that XeF4, we have to discuss XeF6. Next one, XeF6. XeF6. So this is XeF6. Its name is xenon hexafluoride. Its name is xenon hexafluoride. First we find oxidation state. X plus 6 into minus 1 equal to 0. X minus 6 equal to 0. X equal to what happened? 6. X equal to 6. 6 means 6 unpaired electron will be take space. Now 6 unpaired electron will be take space means which excitation state? Now first what happened? NH2NP6. NH2NP6. So what is then first one? Ground state. S it contain 1, 2. And P contain 3 orbitals and 6 electrons. And now first excitation state. S it contain 1 orbital electron and P contain 3 orbitals and 5 electrons and D contain 5 orbitals and 1 electrons. Of course here only unpaired electrons 2. But here one is oxidation state 6. That simply unpaired electrons are depend upon oxidation states are depend upon unpaired electron. Now let us go to second excitation state. S it contain 1, 2 and P contain 1, 2, 3, 4 and D contain 5 or last 12. Here only 4, but here only 6. The remaining unpaired electrons enter in third excitation state. The remaining unpaired electrons enter in third excitation state. That's why S is contains 1, 2, and P contains 1, 2, 3, and D contains 5 or tasks, 3 electrons. So here, how many in the third exercise I said, there are 6 unpaid electrons. Here in the HCFC, also 6 unpaid electrons. So what is the hydrogen in? It undergoes sp3d3. It undergoes sp3d3. How many? 1 s orbital, 3 p orbital, and 3 d orbital. Total 7 sp3d3 hybrid orbital is formed. These 7 sp3d3 hybrid orbital undergoes octahedral. Disrupted octahedral. It's above the molecule is disrupted octahedral. How draw the structure of disrupted octahedral? Here xenon is the center metal. So this is disrupted octahedral. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One paired electron. So this is paired electron. These contain what happened? Fluorine. These all contain fluorine. There are 6 fluorine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That shape of the molecule is disrupted octahedral. What is the in this disrupted octahedral? First one, hybridization is sp3d3. Its shape of the molecule is disrupted octahedral, and lone pair of electron is 6. Lone pair of electron is 6, and lone pair of electron is 1, 2, 1. Lone pair of electron is 1. Bond pair of electron is 6. Total number of orbital is 7. And then exaltation state is third exaltation state. This is XCF6. So XCF2, XCF4, XCF6. This is completely xenon halides. After the xenon halides, we have to discuss xenon oxides. So that is completely xenon halides. Next one, xenon oxides. Xenon oxides are two types. That is first one, HCO3. This is HCO3. First we find oxidation state. X plus 3 into minus 2 equal to 0. X minus 6 equal to 0. X equal to 6. Now, directly, here 6 means 6 unpaired electrons are which excitation state. Now, this is directly third, of course, third excitation state. Now, NH2 NPC, now the ground state, yes, it contains 1, 2, and P contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the first excitation state, yes, it contains 1, 2, and P contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and D contain 5 orbitals, 1 electron. Now in the second excitation state, yes, it contain 1, 2, and it contain 1, 2, 3, 4, and D contain 5 orbitals and 2 electron. Now let us in the third excitation state, yes, it contain 1, 2, and P contain 1, 2, 3, and D contain 5 orbitals, 3 electrons. What we observed in this HCO3, here 3 oxidation state, 6 unpaired electrons. Here 3 oxidation state and 6 unpaired electrons is there. That means in the previous topic what happened? 2 fluorine, 2 oxidation state. 4 fluorine, 4 oxidation state. 6 fluorine, 6 oxidation state. But here 3 fluorine, 6 oxidation state. Now 6 oxidation state means 6 unpaired electrons will be takes place in third excitation state. Of course, if oxygen is there, sigma electron pi electron will be formed. So out of in the third excitation state, there are 6 unpaired electrons. Out of 6 unpaired electrons, the first 3 unpaired electrons are sigma electrons. Other 3 unpaired electrons are pi electrons. The first 3 unpaired electrons are sigma electrons. Other 3 unpaired electrons are pi electrons. Now it undergoes sp3 hybridization. How many? 4. It means 4. That means in the third excitation state, there are 6 unpaired electrons. Out of 6 unpaired electrons, the first 3 unpaired electrons are called sigma electrons. Other 3 unpaired electrons are called pi electrons. sigma electrons are participating in hybridization, pi electrons are, they do not participate in hybridization. Now sp3 hybridization is formed, which means 4 equivalent hybrid order is formed. Its shape of the molecule is pyramidal. Its shape of the molecule is pyramidal. How are the pyramidal? Xenon 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Oxygen. This is lone pair. This is sigma pi. Sigma pi. 3 sigma 3 pi. That's why it ratio is 1:1. This HCO3 is a explosive compound. Now what is in this HCO3? So this is HCO3. This HCO3 is a explosive compound. Its bond angle is 107 degrees. Now let us last one, HCO4. In the xenon oxide, last topic is HCO4. Its oxidation state, what happened? X+4 × −2 = 0. X − 8 = 0. X = 8. 8 means directly. First one, ground state. So ground state, first excitation state, second excitation state, third one, this one. Yes, it contains 1, 2, and P contains 1, 2, 3, and D contains what are them? 1, 2, 3. Okay. But this is first say as it is, second say as it is, third one. But fourth excitation state, this lower pair represents that side. That means here 8 and 5 electron is there, but here only 6. So what happened? Yes, it contains 1, P contains 1, 2, 3. S it contain 1 and P contain 1, 2, 3 and D contain 5 orbitals, 4 electrons. So that means out of 8 unpaired electrons, the first 4 unpaired electrons are sigma electrons, other 4 unpaired electrons are pi electrons. Sigma electrons are participating in hybridization, pi electrons are, they do not participating in hybridization. That's why its hybridization is sp3. It is 4sp3. Its shape of the molecule is tetrahedral. So xenon is the central metal. It contains 4 oxygen. 1, 2, 3, 4. That means 4 sigma, 4 pi. So its bond angle is 109 degrees, 28 minutes. So of course, HCO3 also sp3 hybridization. HCO4 also sp3 hybridization. Both sp3 hybridization, but here presence of lone pair of electron, here absence of lone pair of electron. That's why its bond angle is 107 degrees. That bond angle is 109 28 minutes. So this is noble gas elements, xenon halides, HCF2, HCF4, HCF6, and then xenon oxide, HCO3, HCO4. Then remaining topic is there. The remaining topic will be discussed on next class. Okay.